Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I'm in the field like a panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael V in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens cross the border.
Hold up, you know I'm a touchdown with the sack. Run up the whole life, so running back on the play. Intercept the pack like a safety, you boys had shake the play.
Today, from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Alex Smith and the Washington football team.
And we're about 5 miles northwest of downtown Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Washington football team. Forward to this one all week, and off we go from Tampa. Takes it at the 7. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. Always fun to get a peek at Tom Brady as he gets in place to command this offense for Tampa Bay.
And what's a quarterback's best friend?
Balance.
I think you're right. I agree with you. You know, a lot of guys would say great receiver, right? A terrific offensive line. But I agree with you, balance, because if you can run the ball effectively, that just opens things up for guys who want to throw it and gives you easier passing lanes and easier coverages to read.
And they said balance will be a focus in this one.
Yeah, they don't want it all just heaped on his shoulders, I don't believe. I think they want to make sure they take some of the pressure off.
Throwing on first down is Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Michael Kendricks coming in to drop him. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability. And a sack resulted.
So a tough early challenge here, second and long after the sack. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And boy, this burgundy and gold defense charged up now. They stop him behind the line again. They lose two on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up.
Thank you.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Shotgun now for Brady. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. This will be fielded at the 17.
Washington.
A good work bringing that one back as he picks up about 16 on the return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. So out comes the Washington offense onto the field. They'll be led out by a man who's taken a long and courageous road back to the NFL, their veteran quarterback, Alex Smith.
And what I enjoyed watching this week when we had a chance to watch them at practice, the easy camaraderie that he has with his offense.
A lot of respect.
A lot of respect, and frankly, I thought it spilled over to the defense. All the defensive guys were coming over and teasing and joking with him. You can tell they respect the heck out of him and really want to play well for him.
On first down, it's Smith. Short throw to the tight end, Thomas. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
10 yards on
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Looking to go back to Thomas again, and it's third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. And some space here. And he's going to wind up getting this all the way down to the Buccaneers 18. 38 yards on the scamper there.
It always seems like a lightning bolt when you get a big run on third and inches. But in this case, all the credit has to go to the offensive line. They out-leveraged the defensive front and created a gap for him to get through and create that big-time run.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give.
Number 35.
2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired, I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Out of the gun, Smith. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown. And Washington has taken a first quarter lead. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turned into his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. It's good, and Washington will take a 7-0 lead. Five plays there on that drive. And it was polished off by a Washington touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And right away, he'll look to throw. He finds his tight end, Howard. That's complete. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
Well, they weren't able to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter, it's a good running back dive play.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. From the gun, it's Brady. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 11 yards there, 1st down.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. And it's Reuben Foster in on the tackle.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Working from the gun, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
10 more for him on that one. He's been a busy man. It's a 1st down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On 1st and 10, here's Brady. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle. Going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Brady's throw there complete. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. Brady to throw again. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. Chase Young gets in there to drop him for a loss of 13 yards, and it's also 4th down now. And, partner, it's safe to say that the secondary really contributed to that sack.
Yeah, nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They covered everything, nowhere to go with the football. But my question is, why didn't he throw it away?
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds.
At their own 29-yard
line. Now Washington going to retake the field for drive number two. They have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Smith. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 yards on the play, first down. They're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you've said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the gun, here's Smith. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
To Terry McLaurin. A gain of 9 brings up second and 1 at the Buccaneers' 37-yard line.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. Eluding the pressure right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Smith going to throw on third and 1. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. And it's a fake here on fourth and inches. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. Well, the fake punt gets only a yard, but that's enough to pick up the first. And they were right in that gray area on the edge of long field goal range, maybe too short to punt it. So the defense probably was expecting this was a possibility.
They should have been. And in most cases, what you do on defense is you go to what they call punt safe. In other words, you leave your defense on the field, prepare for them to possibly go for it, and then you just have a little bit different responsibilities. You're not really trying to get a big return. You just want to make sure you get the ball back. But they fell asleep at the switch. Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. A shotgun snap for Smith. and his throw's going to be incomplete. Kelvin Harmon, the man he was looking for, and that'll make it third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. From the gun, Smith. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down. I don't want to blow it too out of proportion, but maybe circle this play, because if they get the stop and hold them to a field goal here, that's a pretty good job. They're already down on the scoreboard.
A stop now would be vital for them, because it could save them from having to do it multiple times later in the game in order to either get back into it or maybe have a chance to win.
So now on fourth down, Washington will hand things over to their kicker, Dustin Hopkins. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And that will make it 10-0 here in the first. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them 3, not 6.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there, 10-play drive, but they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. And for the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From the 6. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
Over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They look to get something started. They need to. Down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. Start the drive with a carry by Jones. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Jones, the ball carrier.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now Brady. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
To the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Operating from the gun, Brady. He's got Evans. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That gain on 3rd down, good for 28.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
In Washington territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. How about Jonathan Allen there pushing upfield to make the stop behind the line?
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Hey, 10, 380. 6 right there, 56. go, D, tighten up. Let's go, D, tighten up.
Now on second and 13.
Brady.
Evans has it left side. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. How about the first quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes his fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings. For some reason, it builds up. For this guy, day game, and he is off and running. You're exactly right. 100 might be conservative with the start that he's had here in the first quarter.
Yeah, by the numbers, he's on pace for 200-plus right now. On the crossing route, complete. That's Evans. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So first and 10 now from the 30. They go back to the ground with Jones. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Tackle made by Thomas Davis.
A quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. From the gun, Brady. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Montez Sweat able to get him down for a loss of 11. And it brings up fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports.
Buccaneers nothing.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he's on to punt for Tampa Bay. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this will be up to the ruling of the side judge here. He says it crossed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. Getting set to go again as we look at the back, heading onto the field again. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the second quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had.
Right.
Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here. On first and 10, Smith. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Fake, and it's Smith. Got an open man, it's Harmon. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
Complete to Kelvin Harmon. A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4 at the 34-yard line.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Now Smith. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 15 yards on the play, first down.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
First down, Smith. And a sideline pass that's caught by Thomas. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
From the 50, it's Smith. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that is going to set up a 3rd and 1.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a 3rd down.
Washington on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Oh, they go with a tight end carry. And that one going nowhere from the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
This defense is really flowing around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Now the former Oklahoma Sooner, Tress Way, on to punt the football. Back deep, Jadon Mickens. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest, right down at the 1-yard line. The spotlight now focuses on the quarterback, and that's Tom Brady. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. 1st and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. And now where are they going to mark him here? Well, they say he did get back to the 1-yard line, but that could have easily been 2 points the other way.
Really shouldn't be a surprise. It's going to be hard to move people in this situation. You know they're going to bring the pressure defensively. Because I remember playing in these spots, and my coach was always say, don't be afraid to try and create a safety, too. They're going to bring pressure.
Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
The Bucs on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. Operating from the gun, Brady. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
This offense has definitely been slow getting out of the gate. It's almost like they missed their wake-up call for this one. No points on their first two possessions, and now it's looking like none on this one either.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. The 39-yard punt, a return of five, and Washington will have a short field here as they take over first and 10. Time again to see Terry McLaurin in the Washington offense. They've got the lead. They haven't really had to utilize him all that much so far, but I guess if you're winning on the scoreboard, not too much to complain about.
Not at all, but you know those guys out wide. They want as many catches as they can possibly get. They may need him later on if things get a little tighter.
Yeah, so far, two catches. We'll see what happens here as the game progresses. Smith on first down. Incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best design plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Throwing again. Smith. Open man here. Sims complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. Now it's Smith. And he finds McLaurin. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Well, they only needed a small gain on third down. They end up getting over 30 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited about what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on second and third down here.
Back at the two now, here's second and goal. Throwing is Smith. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington.
To Steven Sims.
Steven Sims there to make the grab. And Washington going to add on to their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever, there it results in a touchdown. On is Hopkins now for the extra point. He's got it, and it's 17-0. The drive summary that time, five plays. And the result, a touchdown for Washington. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
The Bucs take over first and 10.
Mike Evans of the Tampa offense about to set up shop. He's up near 100 yards now here in the second quarter, but his team's down.
Through no fault of his own. I mean, what a nice game he's having so far. They've got to keep finding ways to get him the football. Don't get away from that. Figure out where things are going wrong with the rest of the team.
They'll be hoping to hit that 100-yard mark on this drive. Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 22. Off the play fake, he'll set up to throw it. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. Give him 6 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brady to Evans on the slant. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Looking downfield for Godwin. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
An attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. To throw again, Brady. And he finds Howard complete. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
The Bucs on 3rd down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Again, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 27 yards there on a very nice 3rd down conversion. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Now Jones. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defense in front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. He'll get the 1st down and more inside the 20. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. Give him 14 on that one and a 1st down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
First time into the red zone for the Buccaneers. They have a 1st and 10 at the 18. Oh. This is Jones. Breaks a tackle, and he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3.
Jones, the ball carrier.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
The 15-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Jones. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The Bucs on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. Here it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that.
Jones, the ball carrier.
He needed 3, he got 2. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard.
When a good play is made on defense, oftentimes leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting turned, all the other guys making sure they're in the right spot. And on that play, they were able to stop him short of a first down.
On 4th down, Ryan Succop now for the Buccaneer field goal. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And they're on the board at least here. It's now 17-3.
17. Buccaneers 3.
So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, probably that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
Bradley,
the punter Pinion now to kick this one away. From the 6. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Will take over 1st and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Alex Smith and company heading back out there now. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Levante David in on the tackle.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, Smith. Catch is made. It's Harmon. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
And that will be incomplete.
That might be the 3rd down stop that they needed, because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
Here's Tressway now, on presumably to punt, though he did complete a pass earlier. Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Mike Evans and the rest of the offensive unit heading back out there now. Making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but he's shredding defenses, getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blow, it's the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
A little tired, and if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
First down carry, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32.
He wasn't ready. He wasn't ready.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. The throw on second down by Brady is incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third down. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Shotgun now for Brady. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Running right through him. It's a return of four following a 42-yard punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Alex Smith and the offense heading out for their next possession. They've got the lead. He's a big reason why, looking sharp so far.
And as we travel around the league, we see quarterbacks get it done in a variety of ways. But today's NFL does tell us one thing. If that guy doesn't play well, their team's not going to win. And right now, he's got his team in the lead.
And now they'll look to extend that lead. Now a first down throw. It's Smith. Flushed out right. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Smith. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Smith. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Not much there, only a yard.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And Washington now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. second and 9 from the 44. From the gun, here's Smith. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35.
Top Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
And we shift to spotlighting Mike Evans. He's done his part, but so far it's been in a losing effort, so they've got to fix something.
But that doesn't mean changing anything, the way they're throwing the ball around and his catches in production. Keep doing that. They're going to have to fix some things likely on defense to try and slow down their opponents.
But so far, he's north of 100 yards receiving. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. It's complete to Brown, right side. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Brady now on first down. That's caught by Howard. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Working from the gun, it's Brady. There's the Penn State man, it's Chris Godwin. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Play fake, Brady. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Godwin. Chris Godwin, as the first half is winding down. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game. Until that late score here in the second quarter, they only had the field goal. So that's just big to see that football get into the end zone.
Yeah, and when you look at the scoreboard now, nothing seems out of reach. They've been outplayed in the first half. But when the clock hits zeros as they head into the half, you know what I do as a head coach?
What?
I tell my team to sprint to the locker room to show that we've got the momentum and show that we're right back in this game.
Ryan Succop on for the point after. And it's up through the goalposts. It's 17-10. A drive there of just 4 plays. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs.